All right, so continuing on with this idea of reacting based on what's going on in the game, we actually get a number of objects passed to us that contain information. And so, for example, here we looked at our energy to see if we wanted to fire or not. But we could do something different when we scan a robot by looking at their energy. And the way that we do that, when we scan a robot, when our radar flashes across the screen and we hit a robot, it generates an on-scanned robot event. And what happens at that moment in time is that it's like it snaps a picture of what's going on. And it takes all that information and passes it to us in this scanned robot event class. And so if we go to look at that class by pulling up the API, and on the left-hand side, there's a scanned robot event class that we imported when we imported the RoboCode library. And it tells us some information about it, but then it has the method summary showing the different methods that we can get. And one of the things that we can do, and maybe rather than doing get energy, just to make it a little less confusing, since we already used get energy with our other robot, and then we'll come back to this example, is to get the distance of the robot. Since we fire bullets faster, the smaller they are, maybe if a robot's a long ways away, we only want to fire with the power of one because the bullet will get there faster, and maybe there's a greater chance of it striking its target. Whereas if it's closer to us, then maybe we want to fire with a higher power, like a power of three. And so what happens is that we scan a robot as our radar is sweeping across, and we receive this scanned robot event that's the snapshot of that scanned robot. And by the way, if the radar keeps going and it scans another robot, it'll generate the event again. It'll generate a whole new scanned robot event object, and it'll pass it to us. And it does that every time it scans a robot. So you can imagine this is happening hundreds of times during the game. And so we want the information about that object. So if I say if get distance is less than, let's say, 200. Okay, so if the distance away is less than 200, then we want to fire with a power of 3. Else, fire with a power of one. Okay? Now this is going to yell at me when I try to compile this. I'm going to save this and compile it, and it's going to say, I have no idea what this get distance method is. Which is kind of frustrating because we just looked at it in the API. There it is, get distance. But the get distance method doesn't belong to the robot class, right? Where is the get distance method? It's part of the scanned robot event class that was passed to us. When that scanned robot event was passed to us, we called it E. So this is the type of information that's being passed to us, the scanned robot event class, and this is what we're going to call it, E. Now we could call it something different if we wanted to. We could call it event. We could call it blah. We could call it high. Whatever we want to call it, it doesn't matter because it's the name we're giving it that we want to refer to it as. And when I say it doesn't matter, it does matter in terms of it's just like Java. We can't just name it any old thing. We can't name it 123. That's not a good variable name, right? But we can name it whatever we want. So a lot of times we'll just do E. And then the distance that we're referring to is from that scan. So we say E dot get distance. And that means of that scanned robot event that was passed to me, what was the distance that snapshot took? How far was that robot away from me? So if the E dot get distance, referring to the robot that I scan's distance from me, is less than 200, then let's fire with a power of 3. Otherwise, let's fire with a power of 1. Okay, and I don't know how this is going to play out with 200. And again, this isn't necessarily a good strategy. I'm just trying to demonstrate a principles here. So if we go back to the battle and restart this battle, and I've got way too many bots in this battle. Let me get rid of a few bots. Let's take out Ramfire. And we'll take out Walls. And start this battle. Now, it's shooting with smaller bullets. But it's okay, there was a bigger bullet because Crazy was pretty close to me. Now, when it just scanned target, let's see if it does it again. There was a big bullet. There was a big bullet. But when it scans the corners, then it's shooting small bullets because the distance of 200 pixels, the screen's only 800 by 600 or something. So when it's shooting that bullet, it's shooting it with a low power until it gets close. And so if it scans fire over here, it's going to shoot with a big power. Maybe. Anyway, we saw it happening earlier. So that's the idea. Every time this radar flips around and scans a robot, then it generates a new event that has information about that object. And again, the information that it's giving us in the scanned robot event object is get the bearing of that robot, get the bearing and radiance, get the distance, get the energy, get the heading. Where was it, which way was it going? Get the name of the robot. This is why I keep my name secret when I play other students. I would just get destroyed. Get the velocity of the robot. So you could take the velocity, the heading, and the bearing and figure out where the robot's going to be based on the velocity of your bullet. Those of you who are excellent at math could go through and figure that out and lead the robot based on their heading and where they're going. But anyway, that's just one thing we can do. We can make this determination. Now, he scanned that robot. It must not have been quite within 200. But when they get really close, then we start shooting with bigger bullets. Again, we could test this out a little bit easier by saying, let's make the distance, 400. And so if they're really far away, then we're going to shoot with small bullets. Otherwise, we're going to shoot with big bullets. Restart that. So there's big bullets because we're close. If I can live long enough. Now, eventually, when I get back far enough, there we go. There was a shot with a small bullet. Okay, so I backed up a little bit further. Now I'm shooting with the small bullets. Again, there was a big bullet, so I was right on the border of that 400 in that particular example. There I'm shooting with small bullets because they're all close, and as soon as I scan Crazy here, except for I keep shooting first when I scan corners, so. Anyway, you get the point. I don't need to sit here and watch this forever. Or at least I hope you get the point. Well, what about other events? What other ons are there? We got on scanned robot. We've got on hit by bullet. We've got on hit wall. Let's go look at the RoboCode API. That was not it. And look in the robot class, what other ons do we have? On method. So we have a lot of them. On battle ended, when the battle's done. On bullet hit. What do you want to do when the bullet hits whatever its target was? When one of your bullets hits, what do you want to do? On bullet hit bullet. What if your bullet hits another bullet? That's probably a good call to get out of the way because somebody's shooting at you, right? And you're shooting at them. On bullet missed. When your bullet misses, what do you want to do? On death. Now, this is more like debugging purposes. On hit by bullet. On hit robot. What do you want to do when you hit another robot? How about if I hit a robot, I want to ram that robot. I want to back up and ram that robot. So this is a method that's not in there to begin with, but it's a method that's part of the robot class. So I need to put that method into my class and then put some code in it. And so it actually gives me the code here to create this event. So I can come down here below on hit wall and I can create my own event here, public void on hit robot. If I hit another robot, then it tells me I want to pass in a hit robot, or what's going to be passed in is a hit robot event. And then I can give it a name. I'll just call it E like we've done on the other ones. And now I can say, what do I want to do when I hit a robot? We call this overriding a method. There was already a method in there that was blank. Now I'm going to override it with my code to, I shouldn't say, I don't know if it was blank, but I'm now going to override it with my code. So I've written the method out just like it had it here in the API. And now I can do it, and I actually gave an example here of what to do. What was the bearing of the robot? If the bearing was less than 90 degrees and event was greater than the bearing, or sorry, and the event bearing was greater than 90. So in other words, if it's ahead of you, if you got hit from in front, that must be behind us or it wouldn't make any sense. If the bearing's between negative 90 and 90, then we want to back up they are trying to back up. That doesn't make sense. Wow. See, I'm 11 minutes and 30 seconds into it. I can't go back now. So the angle is relative to your robot's facing, so 0 is straight ahead of you. Anyway, so in here I can say if I want to ram the robot. If I hit a robot, I want to go back 100, not even 100, let's just go back 50, and then forward, well, sorry, that's not forward, it's ahead by 100. I want to ram through that robot. Now it'll actually stop once it hits the robot, but that's what I want to do if I hit a robot, and I want to keep doing it. And as soon as I hit the robot, it'll generate another on-hit robot event, and I'll hit that robot again. So let's try this. I'll compile this and run it. If I can find that, there we go. So let's restart this battle and watch what happens when I ram a robot. If I ram a robot. Okay, I just hit that guy. Okay, there we go. Now I'm ramming. Okay, this isn't effective because he has more energy than me, so he's going to destroy me, but I am getting some ram points. Okay, here we go again. So that's kind of the similar technology that the ram fire uses. Once you scan somebody, then go in and back up and ram them, depending on this idea that you're going to kill them and get this big bonus for killing them with rams instead of killing them with bullets. Okay, so that's another kind of concept of what we can do by adding in another method that's not already in there that belongs to the RoboCode API. It belongs to the robot class. There's in the robot class, there's an onHitRobot method that we can use. And so you can go through any of these and say, I want to, on a win, I want to do a little victory dance, right? So there's lots of different methods we can look at there to do that are generated when an event occurs. All right? I used this example this morning, in fact, in one of my classes, that when a fire alarm goes off, that's the event that occurred. What do we do? Well, we all stand up and walk out. So we're programming what happens when that event is triggered. All right, we'll look at a couple other things in the next video, and I think that should be it. Spencer out.